Hey guys, welcome to the Word of Encouragement today. Hope that you're doing well. My name is still Albert, hasn't changed, will not change. Coming from the book of 2 Timothy, we'll read from verse 11 to 13. Here is a trustworthy saying: if we died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we disown him, he will also disown us. If we are faithless, he will remain faithful, for he cannot disown himself. I'll read verse 13 again. If we are faithless, he will remain faithful, for he cannot disown himself. I'll give you a short story just to put verse 13 into context. And it's about the Israelites. So we meet the Israelites in Exodus chapter 1. We meet the Israelites in Egypt. And by this time, Joseph had already died, generations had passed, the people of Israel had already even grown, they had multiplied. And so a new king was installed who neither knew Joseph or even the things that he did. So Akangalia, the people, and how everything is going around, he was like, who are these guys who are not Egyptian? And he was told, they are called the Israelites. They came here when there was a king. He was like, no, there are too many. If they decide to gang up against us one day, watatushinda, because they're really, like, there were a lot of people. And you know, God's promise to Abraham was that they're going to become a great nation. They're going to multiply. And this is what they were doing while they were in Egypt. And so Pharaoh akasema, you know, let's make them our slaves. They'll work for us. They'll do everything that, you know, the dirty little things. They're going to be the ones to do it. So akafanywa makywm. So they were put over them. They had slave masters, slave drivers, they were oppressed, and they became so devastated by this that Moses, this is when God actually now rose up Moses. So he grew up in Egypt, in a palace. You know the story of Moses, Alizaliwa, and then he was put in a basket, and then Nini. You can go read how Moses now came into the palace. He was an Israelite. And then 40 years he was in Egypt, and then he killed someone, Akatupwa Midian. He went to Midian, and then 40 years he stayed there, and then God came and called him and told him, Moses, go back to Egypt and tell Pharaoh to let my people go. That was the main message that Moses was getting from God. So he goes back to Egypt, goes to Pharaoh and tells him, I come to you, I have a message from God, and he has said, let my people go. So we know how the story goes. Pharaoh amekata, and then there were plagues. 10 plagues came. There were gnats. There were locusts. There were, locusts zilikam, kulikuwa pia na ile plague ya maji, became blood. And then the last one was so deadly that Pharaoh and his people were like, hey, our sons have died. So let these people go. I mean, wametuletea shida mob. So when wameachiliwa, they're going out with Moses. Pharaoh akaangalia hivi akaona makywm wetu wameishia. So what do we do now? So he decided, let's take all the chariots that we have. And he took 600 of the best chariots, 600 of them. And then those were the ones who were going to ride with Pharaoh himself. And then they also got all the other chariots to go behind them when they were collecting the Israelites back to Egypt, back to slavery and to oppression. So of course the Israelites, when you wanatembea, they are now free, they know what's going on. And then they hear horses and chariots behind them coming. And they start telling Moses, yo, what's going on? Tumeanza kutafutwa na kina nani tena, na kina Pharaoh tena. So, I mean, and you know how the story goes. God decided to take them all the way to the Red Sea, and then they get to the Red Sea. Moses parts the way, and the Bible says that they walked on dry ground. Like dry ground. Unavenye kuna nyeshange, and then kuna matope. This guy is actually passed on dry ground. So God parted the waters of the Red Sea, and then they passed. Now they're in the wilderness. God comes, gives them manna, quail. He gives them water. He gives them food. Like, they're sorted. In terms of basic needs, they're sorted. So they've seen God's faithfulness twice. Twice now. Time of Passover, when they were now released. And then the Red Sea was parted. So now they're in the wilderness. Moses goes up to the mountain. He gets the Ten Commandments, comes with other laws, and give them to the Israelites. I'm just paraphrasing because it's a long story. And then when they get that, the law, in Exodus chapter 24, this is what the Israelites say. We will obey. Everything that you've said, we will do. Twice they say that, we will obey. Everything that you have said, we will do. And then Israelites now, Moses of course comes down, gives them that law. They agree to everything that they have said. And then a few chapters later, Moses is on the mountain again, 40 days in Mecca. He's there for 40 days and they are now wondering, Moses alikufa. What's going on? Probably went to the mountain and then he was killed by God. Maybe he did something. So they tell Aaron, make us a golden calf. And in Exodus chapter 32, Aaron says to Moses, don't be angry, my Lord. You know how prone these people are to evil. And this is mankind. All mankind, we're all prone to evil. And so what they decided to get an idol and start, you know, worshipping it, saying that this golden calf is the one that's going to lead us, where God was supposed to lead us. So, of course, now as you go on, God gets angry, but he forgives them. This is the third time that God has given them his faithfulness. And then now we jump all the way to Numbers. Now, Moses is still with them. He sees that is the promised land, Ikopale Evo. And he sends 12 guys, Joshua and Caleb are part of those. So they go to the promised land, they check it, and then they come back and they give a report. They're like, that land is enyewe, flowing with milk and honey. Like it's green, the produce is, there's so much vineyards, there's so much, you know, produce, it bears much fruit, let's go in and take it. But then the 10 other guys who come back, they say, hey, these guys have so much structure, there's armies, you know, kunama soldiers, kila mali, you know, there's walls built around this town, and they're like, we can't do this. We're not able to go and beat these guys. I mean, we're not even warriors. Nikama sasa utuambia tuende Egypt tukachukua hiyo land. So they tell Moses, you know what we'll do? Give us another leader, us we'll go back to Egypt. And then you guys go to the promised land. And so now here God was like, okay, Noah said here three times and you still haven't seen my faithfulness. So we know what you'll do. You'll chop up laps, 40 years you'll be in the wilderness. And that's how they came to be there in the wilderness for 40 years. They were supposed to just pass through and get to Canaan. But because of their unfaithfulness, walichapua 40 years wakae huko hivyo. And that whole generation, none of them except Joshua and Caleb got into this promised land. So what am I saying today? This is how we face our next challenges. And the message for today is facing your next challenge is that you go back and see what God has done for you. All the little things that God has done for you, they're the foundations of what God will help you in your next challenge. And so for when that thing comes before you, uiangalievi useme challenge. This is you. Unaiangalievi unaangalia challenge. This is you. Yeah. Do you know what we have been through with God? You're like, this is what God has done for me before. And be like, challenge, you don't know what my God can do. And so when you're going through life, and the Bible says that God takes you from strength to strength. And so he will take you from a smaller challenge to a bigger challenge. And when that bigger challenge comes, just remind yourself that God is faithful. He has done it before. He will do it even now. And so I pray that as we go through this season, as we go through even the next season of our lives, that we will see and trust that God carries us, that God provides us, and that he's able to carry us into the promised land that he has for us. So this is my prayer for you, and be blessed.